Heat is crucial in our understanding of time. The only equations in physics where we see the future different from the past are the equations which describe heat, temperature. Heat goes from a hot body to a cold body and not vice versa. So it gives a direction of time. And in our experience, every time there's a sense of flowing time, there's some heat. We think in our head in time, and our head produces heat. Mechanics, which is a science of things without heat, does not distinguish future from the past. So heat is the key toward understanding time. And I think that it's a key because heat and temperature are averaged notions. So heat is a lot of molecules moving fast. It's not a thing, heat. It's a fast motion of molecules. And it's a way of viewing this motion at a scale where you don't see the individual motion, you just see the big effect of many things. And I think the time is something similar. Time is something that begins to make sense when you have many, many things moving fast and you don't look at the details, you look at the average. That's why it refers to us, because we have an imprecise notion, vision, of some part of the universe, and it is in this imprecision that times come in. I've written, to put it in a slogan, that times is related to our ignorance.